even know her. What does that mean?
It means flake off, nerdo.
Nerdo? I'm Victor the Magnificent, the ultimate fighter, right, Joel, my boy?
Whatever.
Looks like they served grump pills at lunch today.
Do you realize what's gonna happen to us today? We've gotta get on a bus and ride all the way to... Where is this place?
Coltoy.
Wherever that is. And then we've gotta work tonight and tomorrow in a wax museum.
It's violating our rights.
We don't have any rights.
We've been sentenced to summer school.
I mean, look on the bright side. If we do this museum thing, we'll be paroled at least 2 days early.
I knew I should have spent more time on history.
And how much time did you spend?
Absolutely none.
Rolf, you're not listening.
Heather, Miss Fairchild, I'll rake all the leaves in your yard.
No.
I'll let you through to me every afternoon, 3 weeks, six.
Rolf, passing summer school is your only chance. You blow it, you blow American history. You blow American history, you don't graduate.
Oh, come on.
Forget it, Rolf. She's a teacher. She's immune to charm.
I wouldn't exactly put it like that.
But the thing is, I have a date tonight with Ellie Standish. She's a direct descendant of Footsie Standish, the guy who told us about where the pilgrims landed.
Footsie?
It was Miles Standish, dope!
I knew it had something to do with measurements.
Sorry, Rolf, but after that, I'd say you ought to flunk history, even if you survive summer school.
Okay, no, Heather, Miss Fairchild, I'll even wear a smile, see?
I don't know how you're going to make it to your date anyway, since we're staying overnight in Cultley, remember? Better call and cancel. That is, if you really do have a date.
ladies, no need to be jealous. Perhaps one of you would be so kind to share your sleeping bag.
I'm sure there'll be no need to share, Rolf. Now, has anybody seen Lupe?
I saw her at Wendy's. Sometimes she works the register, even cooks.
She's got like two jobs, Miss Fairchild.
Three. She just started at the Starlight Theater.
Oh dear, I hope she makes it. The bus driver told me he wouldn't wait. So, are we all excited?
No.
We'll have a good time, really. My aunts are so nice and they're very glad we're coming. They can use all the help they can get to open the wax museum on time. It'll be a real tourist attraction in Cultley.
It sounds so creepy. Wax museums are always creepy.
Yeah, like Madame Tussauds. I hear she's got a chamber of horrors and you can see victims.
Thank you, Joel! But wax museums are not creepy. Besides, this isn't just a wax museum. There'll be all sorts of other interesting historical items on display.
Miss Fairchild, interesting historical is an oxymoron.
Good, you made it, Lupe.
You should really quit one of your jobs.
I would, but I'm the only one in my family who's a job right now.
That sucks.
Well, hopefully this will feel like a vacation for all of us.
What am I supposed to tell? What? I can't make it to this date? I'm so cute, man.
Oh, Jolene! Look at this! Ivan is 200 years old!
Ivy! My mother bought this pair for my wedding, and please don't say I'm 200 years old!
Are you sure?
I just feel like it's some time to duck said both knees need replacing.
No, I mean about China.
I'm afraid Ethel's right, dearie. We can check the catalogs, but I'm sure that's Wendover Pottery's number 6 fire sign design.
Why, Hazel, who needs a catalog with you around?
I just can't get enough of this stuff. Imagine, it's all ours.
But Hazel, it isn't ours.
We're just the caretakers, right, Skip?
I think that's the way it goes. But you guys are the Coltoli Historical Society, and Rufus Ravencroft's collection was donated to Coltoli Historical Society. So I guess it's safe to say it's yours.
I knew you were the best handyman who applied for the job here.
Ethel, honey, he was the only handyman who applied.
It's OK. Kate, I'm Mr. Rotella. I have to get my remodeling business off the ground, and you have to get your museum up and running, so we're in what I call a symbiotic relationship.
I've never been in one of those before.
I made it means we're helping each other out.
And preserving the memory of Rufus Ravenscroft.
Well, he was quite the explorer, wasn't he?
Oh, he's the only person in history who visited every single country in his lifetime.
Good news, our helpers are on their way.
That's your niece's history class, right?
Only about 6 students. They're what she called historically challenged.
Ugh, she means a goofball.
They flunked history, so they have to take it in summer school. Heather, can you help us or else?
Or else what?
I don't think Heather, this Fairchild would ever be that mean.
Well, that's right. You two know each other, don't you, Skip?
We graduated from high school together.
Then I'm sure you'll have lots to talk about.
Did we get John Allen's coat press?
Oh, goodness, no!
It's an original. Pressing it might have damaged it.
What about Cleopatra's dress?
That's just a costume piece. All her dresses have disappeared.
I heard she was that kind of woman.
But the jewelry is hers, and in one of his journals, Rufus Ravenscroft said some of her jewelry has magical powers.
Oh, my!
Do you realize we've got the most amazing collection right here?
Oh, we do, and have I told you that Rufus Ravenscroft was in my great-grandmother's class back when Cultley School was just one room?
I heard he couldn't sit still.
That's right. He was always out of his seat, looking out windows, dreaming of some place to go. And when the teacher told him, you'd better sit down and do your work, he told her he'd do his work all around the world. He'd see everything there was to see and bring her back as many wonderful things as he could.
Oh yes, and that's just what he did.
So I see.
Paintings from Paris. Statues from Greece.
Oh, and jewels from Egypt.
And tapestries from Spain. And all those wonderful wax figures he had created.
Commission from Madame Tussauds. Oh, the wax works.
Well, he must have been rolling in dough.
Oh, I heard when he died, he was worth more than all the gold in Fort Knox.
Oh, and if you believe that, I've got a pre-Columbian Aztec mask I can sell ya.
What's that?
We don't know. That's the thing. He only ever mentions it in one letter. He said that he found the most wonderful treasure in the world at a flea market.
But he didn't give a hint as to what it was.
He wasn't the talk of the time, I guess.
What do you expect of a man?
All right. I know what I'm not wanting.
You don't have to go.
I'm gonna put this bench upstairs.
And keep an eye out for Heather. Such a nice young man.
Well, looky here. Is this a rummage sale? I got a very strange feeling none of this junk is for sale.
What are you doing here, Miss Sneed?
I own the building, sweetheart. I can be here anytime I want.
Yes, but you're supposed to give us notice before barging in.
Well, this is your notice. We're here.
I see you brought reinforcements.
This is Polly. Say hello, Polly.
Hello.
Polly wanted a cracker.
Hey, no smart comments about my girl, you hear?
Okay, well, I'll only make the dumb one.
That's not funny, Polly.
How come?
Why, of all the nerve!
Now, Miss Sneed, we're on a very tight schedule. We only have so many hours to get the museum up and running.
So how may we help you? By packing up this junk and getting out of this place.
This place happens to be the Coltilly Wax Museum.
For another 20 years!
We've got a lease.
Yeah. My grandfather's a nutcase signing leases like that.
Rufus Ravenscroft paid decades in advance, and we even have an option to buy.
But things have changed since the old coot kicked the bucket.
Oh, that is no way to talk about one of our country's greatest explorers and our collectors!
Julian and Jolene's uncle, shame on you! We've got treasures from all over the world here!
We've got Cleopatra's jewelry that's worth hundreds of thousands of dollars!
And there's a treasure here that's worth more than Fort Knox!
I
IV!
Oh, Jolene, I heard a bus pull up.
Oh. What bus?
Our niece has brought up some of her history students to help us write museum identification display signs for our museum displays.
Why don't we go up and give them a nice, big welcome?
I just want to try those cookies I baked for the children, Ivy!
I already did!
Oh, why you?
Please make sure to lock the door when you leave, Miss Mead, and we hope it's soon.
And we hope it's soon.
So, what are we gonna do, Ma?
We're gonna get this place no matter what. This old dumpster, I think, is out of the way, and we've called for them all.
And gosh, we need a mall.
It's up to the $5 million they're offering.
Let's just boot them out.
Can't do that. Grandfather signed that lease, and it's tighter than a drum.
I saw a TV show once where they had to break their lease, so they had a band come in and play really loud music and—
Jasper, is this seriously the best you can do? Come on, we gotta find something to get them out of this place.
Well, what if we find the treasure?
It's probably some dumb painting or something.
But won't they do anything to get it back?
Gee, Jasper, maybe being in labor with you for 20 hours was worth it after all. Mind you, gotta find something here worth a bundle.
And so that's all there is to it.
To what?
To what you have to do.
Do you all understand? We've got the notes here.
You'll use the computers in the office and print the information out on these display signs.
And we'll be placing them at the proper exhibits.
Yeah, I know, I'm at some library. Okay, love you too, Ellie. So, what do we have to do?
Oh, dear. We'll tell him.
What were you doing, man?
Brushing my teeth.
Of course you were.
That must be a very good book.
Madame Bovary, some women's lives are just so romantic.
We have some of those women here in the museum, too.
Anne Boleyn and Cleopatra.
Even Calamity Jane.
I never thought of her as a romantic.
Well, she was a man killer in her own way.
I guess.
So who's under here?
Oh, please don't touch. Some of our figures are wearing original clothing. Very delicate.
Don't you have somebody exciting like Dracula?
We've got pirates and outlaws.
Of course. I'll write their stuff.
I'm sure they'll be very pleased.
You talk like you're alive or something.
You'll have to excuse Ivy. These historical characters are like her own children. I claim a few of them, but I won't take blame for most of them.
Once you're finished with the display signs, we'll show you some of the most beautiful things in our collection.
So children, why don't you come over here and look at all the information?
Select the person you'd like to write about. Remember, we knock off that 10.
Make every minute count.
But I hate math!
That our landlords have left the building. Let's go.
You have fun now, you hear?
Have fun!
How? This place is like a mausoleum.
What's that?
A place where you put dead people.
Oh no, 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 don't do this to me!
What's wrong, Carrie? Are you sick?
My battery's dead.
A fitting place to die.
Guys, come on. Who cares about any of this stuff? It's not gonna get me a date this weekend.
Well, these people are 6 feet under.
Some of them without their heads.
That is just so gross.
Hey, look at this guy. He's wearing tights!
And she's wearing her nightgown.
Cool jewelry, though.
Wow, I wouldn't want to have to date this one.
I bet you she could bench like 200 pounds.
Hey, it's the refugees from the Pirates of the Caribbean.
And it sure isn't Johnny Depp.
So, how did we get ourselves into this mess?
We flunked history?
Who cares if Popeye sailed the ocean blue in 1492?
Not me.
And what difference does Manifest Destiny make?
Yeah, like, what'd she ever do for me? I mean, us.
And so what if Confucius said, like, 1,000 crazy things?
Man who run in front of car, get tired. Man who run behind car, get exhausted.
Why?
Get all the instructions, guys?
Do we really have to do all this work?
You wouldn't have to if you had done it during the school year.
But this is hard!
We don't care about any of this stuff.
Amen.
Listen, you're probably all hungry after the bus ride. I just put some sandwiches and drinks in the break room. Go get something to eat, then come back and we'll get started, okay?
Food sounds good to me!
Victor, yes. You don't even know where the break room is!
My nose will lead me to it!
Sandwiches in the break room. Lupe, you doing anything for dinner this evening?
Looks like we're all going to break up for sandwiches,
like Miss Fairchild just said.
We have no other option but to eat with you.
Looks like I'll have a date after all this evening.
Skip?
Yep. You got here.
Sure.
Thought you were bringing some kids.
They're in the break room getting something to eat.
Never figured you for a teacher.
Never figured you for a... what do you do?
I own my own construction business.
Impressive.
Not really. This is my first job.
Mine too. I mean, I guess we have to start someplace.
So, how have you been?
I got over it.
Well, I didn't really mean...
How have I been?
Yeah, right, like, every little thing.
Fine, I've been fine.
Did you get the letters I sent you?
The two you sent freshman year?
Never heard back from you.
Well, I was too busy to write then. I had a boyfriend, and he didn't make a habit of standing me up.
I wouldn't call it a habit.
Oh, only every other date, including senior prom.
I told you, I was backing on the driveway with my truck.
Blew a head gasket and got oil all over your tux.
It's true. I sent you the dry cleaners receipt to prove it.
Yeah, so I sat at home in my $300 dress and watched Indiana Jones and the Temple of Doom.
I didn't fun on it either. There was oil everywhere, and I knew you wanted to go with a date with a guy that smelled like penzoil.
You knew that, didn't you?
Well, would you have?
God, you were always such a know-it-all. You could have called.
I did. I left the message on your machine.
Of course, you took the coward's way out.
Oh, you didn't pick up the phone.
So blame it on me.
Well, you could. You just could be a bit more empathetic.
Meaning?
You could have just come over and helped me clean up the mess.
I hope you're just about done with whatever you're doing here, because I would really like some peace and quiet.
I'll come back later.
Don't bother. I may want to snap with my kids.
Good. You feel as mature as a woman you in high school.
Ah!
Women. Ow! Ah! Ow! Ah! Ah! Miss Fairchild, you have any bandages?
I'm sick of looking everywhere for something we don't even know what it is.
Quit. You're complaining. They almost caught us down there in the basement. Look, we might find something useful down here. Gosh, look at this. Some pretty nice jewelry here, bye. I've seen better stuff at Sears. I hate when it thunders.
Oh, you're just like Judy.
Who's Judy?
Our collie. Come to think of it, there's a resemblance.
Hey, something carved into the back.
What?
I don't know.
Give it to me. You only read tabloids.
Cool, Ma, read it.
Abba, dabba, sabba, snot?
Snot? Dead?
I don't know.
Hope not.
Yeah, we spent eternity with you.
What happened?
The fuse blew.
And just how would you know that?
Because my daddy sounds just like that whenever he blows a fuse.
Hey, something's mighty different about this room.
Well, I don't exactly see that guy's treasure lying around here anywhere.
Treasure?
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 Of course not, Polly. They got that treasure hid real good.
Treasure?
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 Gosh, there sure is an echo in here. Somebody's coming. Hi!
Myself, Thunder, Victor, Thunder.
Oh my God!
Emily, what is it? They're gone. All those wax figures were just there a minute ago. I'm sure somebody just moved them. That's all.
That quickly?
Well, Skip's a pretty fast mover. I mean,
who's Skip?
He does his work really fast. Skip? Mr. Webster, the handyman.
Is he like your boyfriend?
You've got to be kidding.
That would be so cute, just like Wuthering Heights. Except. Tragedy.
Yes.
Hey, do you guys smell something?
Just Victor Thunder.
I resent that! Ew, you smell!
Like turkey? Oh, God.
Something really weird is going on here. Let's go find out where my aunts put the statues. Oh, my God, Victor.
I went to your house. We checked. Cologne, deodorant, something.
Put on something!
Henry.
V8.
That's too long, Shinookum. Can't I just call you Hank?
Well, you can call me anything, just as long as you call me Cleopatra.
Cleo to my good friends.
Imagine, waking up and finding a jolly pretty miss standing next to me.
But where are we? This is not Egypt.
I haven't the foggiest. Oh, it must be a new palace. The queen is always buying new palaces. She goes through gold like it grows on trees. But that doesn't matter now, so long as you're here. And she's far, far away.
We shall spend an eternity together, my love.
Did I mention that I'm not that good at long-term commitments?
Then we shall enjoy whatever time we have together, for I am the mistress of Egyptian love.
And I am the master of English cuisine. Not to mention the king of the falling axe. But don't you worry your pretty little head about that.
Henry, I've got my head back on. Where are we? And what are you doing with her?
Why, honey bunches. We were just talking.
Oh, sure. She's gotta be pretty special to get your mind off of a turkey leg.
Is this your little woman?
Anne Boleyn, the love of my life. Enjoy fights one better, Cleo.
Oh, you dastardly fiend.
You're the fiend. This man is a king.
He sure is the king of fools.
Come on, Hank. Let me take you for a cruise on my barge.
I could use a bit of fresh air.
Guys, I know I can hear someone crying. Hey, look.
She looks like Snow White.
You think the seven dwarfs are around here someplace?
Guys, just back up. Let a boy do a man's job. Say, princess, you got something on your eye. Rolf could take it out for you. Just hold still.
Oh my God. Ah! What? How dare you approach the queen and speak so boldly?
You're like a queen?
The queen of England, and before me thou must kneel.
Okay, Rolf's not kneeling to no one.
Oh,
kneel.
Okay. Listen, lady, I don't know who you are, but you're gonna have to- oh.
Guards!
Oh.
Guards!
There are no guards.
Are you Anne Boleyn? One of the most tragic figures in history?
Tragic? I'll give you tragic. Guards, take them to the tower, off with their heads.
This isn't England, Toots.
See, there aren't any guards. By the way, what year is it, lady?
Every fool knows it's 1535, and the tower is too good for you. You shall rot and to burn before being drawn and quartered!
You can get up now, Rolf.
Get up. Do you guys suppose, like, no?
Nah.
Yo!
What a bottle, of rum!
Oh, it's good to be up and about again.
Aye, and I'm itching for a fight.
But where are we?
This sure ain't Blackbeard's sloop.
Arrrr! Shiver me timbers.
Okay.
Where are we?
God, you know Blackbeard.
You know everything, Captain.
Always have.
All right, then. Tell me which one of you's got the treasure.
None of us, but we heard the word bandied about.
You know what I think, Captain? They took it.
Arr! Us? Shiver me timbers. Ain't shaving yet, but out stealing treasure?
Not us, Mr. Blackjack, sir.
His name's Blackbeard.
The fiercest pirate on the high seas.
And able to make a thief squeal like a stuck pig. And these be? And Bony. Mary Reed. And the diabolical Madam Ching.
Lady pirate?
We ain't been ladies in years.
Is that thing real? Ow, you gotta be careful with something like that.
It's definitely against the school rules.
Yeah, you could get suspended.
Aye, we are to suspend him.
But only the principal can do that, right, guys?
From the Ardor!
With their eyes plucked out.
So the birds will come and eat them.
Not even the assistant principal would do that, by the way.
Yeah,
just saying.
Yeah, I think we'll be going.
Tell me where the treasure is, or you'll walk the plank. Smart one, huh?
I'm in the 76th percentile for reading, but math isn't quite as high.
Where be the treasure?
We don't know about any treasure.
We here tell a lad by the name of Raven Scruft found the greatest treasure fall, and he's got it in nearby.
We will wrestle, it's ours.
And neither will you.
Oh my gosh, is that an albatross?
Baby! The whippersnappers give us a slip!
After all!
You. Thought about retiring Blackbeard, a nice little place in Florida.
Hi, she one of yours, Madam Ching?
Nay, but she made a fine recruit.
Arr, let's go get her.
That was just down in the Colonial Gallery in the where are the wax figurines?
I was gonna ask the same thing.
We didn't do anything with them.
We've been up here looking for the copy of the lease Rufus Ravenscroft signed on this place.
Are you saying the figures are gone? Yes. I was in the main gallery with my kids, and 1 minute the figures were there, and the next minute they were gone.
Only the sheets are left.
Howdy, Boncho. Hola, Butch.
Uh-oh.
You two forgot where we are?
Looks like some newfangled city emporium.
How in tarnation we get here?
Who cares? The only thing that matters is we all heard the magic word. Treasure.
Are you really Butch Cassidy?
Oh,
dreaming?
He ain't Butch. I am.
So you're the Sundance Kid?
What do you guys want?
Last thing I remember was a gunfight in Bolivia.
I was mighty sick in Deadwood.
Calamity Jane.
Howdy, old timer.
And you must be Poncho Villa.
See, but this isn't Chihuahua.
Oh, did you ever hear of Rufus Ravenscroft?
Can't say we have. Well, let me guess. He buried his treasure out here.
And maybe you know where.
Well, we don't know anything about any treasure.
We maybe can make you talk, see?
Oh, dear.
We like to be peaceable, man, as long as we get our way.
Load up our saddlebags with gold.
That's all we ask.
So, where's the loot?
What do we do? Any bright ideas, Mr. Webster?
Why should I be the one with any bright ideas?
You always seem to know everything.
Well, that's a bit fair, John. I don't even know what they're talking about.
You know treasure. Mucho dinero. We want to be rolling the money. And then we get gas at Coriandas and Majores, Macheras, Gugupsos, Casomos, Sotoros, Pestanic, and say, Array.
Pancho! Rinare, partner.
You want the treasure, right?
That's all we're asking.
Well, then all you'll need to do is, I guess, go out that door. Two flights of stairs, that'll take you to the main floor. Find the third door on your left, that'll take you to the jewelry gallery. Find the exhibit that says ancient amulets, and it's in a little box behind a case.
That's a powerful lot to remember.
Third door on the left.
Little box.
We're much obliged, man. And if we don't find nothing, we'll be back.
And we won't be so nice.
Adios.
Angeline, what's going on?
Oh, but somehow those wax figures came to life. In all my glory, they're just as I thought they'd be.
But what are we gonna do about them?
As long as they can find the treasure, we'll be fine.
Oh, great. But we don't even know if there is a treasure.
What treasure?
Oh, poor Rufus Ravenscroft gonna be cryptic in his old age and wrote in a letter to a friend that he finally got his hands on the greatest treasure the world has ever known.
And we've hunted and hunted, but nothing. Cleopatra's jewelry is the closest thing we've come to a real treasure.
And I'll give it all to you, Your Highness!
Please, have of no theory like a woman scorned.
Your Majesty
and Queen Cleopatra,
two secret lovers in need of a hiding place.
Emily would be thrilled to see this.
Henry, where are you?
Help us, please!
Behind the desk, quick!
Henry? Have any of you seen a king running around here with a floozy about? This tall?
Floozy?
Who said that?
I did. It's such a quaint word.
So where are they?
Just go out that door, two flights of stairs, third door on your left, in the jewelry gallery.
Figures. She wants my man and the crown jewels. Everything all right, my dear?
I don't think they put my head back on quite right.
But I'll get used to it. Hear that, Henry? You can't keep a good woman down!
If they, you can come out now.
Good subjects. Your king thanks you.
And I am eternally grateful.
Hey!
Look it off, Cleo.
Aha! Ah! So you thought you could outthrot me?
I thought we'd taken care of that clever head on your shoulders.
Ah!
I can't believe my eyes.
They both come alive.
And they're biting them off.
I have to get my kids.
Oh, I'll help.
No! I don't need a man to tell me if my students thank you.
Oh, dear. Heather seems a bit put out. Did you two have a fight, Scott?
Yep. 5 years ago. I'm gonna go check at the last
got it!
Is that the lease?
The lease between Rufus Ravenscroft and Sebastian Sneed.
Good. At least one thing's going right.
We'll just take Mr. Violet Sneed and tell her.
Tell me what?
To take a hike.
Why, of all the nerve.
Jasmine, shut her up.
Shut up, Polly.
You can't break this lease. We've done everything to the letter.
Check page 3, section 4, paragraph 1.
What's it say, Essel?
If at any time the lease is called holding wild parties, including but not limited to excessively loud music,
you miserable excuse for royalty!
Me? You're nothing but a scullery maid in Queen's closet!
Or a discharge of firearms, the lease shall be considered null and void.
Well, you haven't heard any firearms.
Bang! Bang! Take that, you dirty vermin!
Oh, dear. We've got to do something.
Yeah, you're gonna clear out right now.
Where'd you get that bracelet?
Jasper gave it to me.
That belongs to Cleopatra.
Well, it looks a whole lot better on Polly.
Give it back. No way. It's engraved for me and everything.
Engraved?
Yeah, a real funny saying carved on the back.
What's this say?
How should I know? Abba-dabba something or other. How should I know? It looks Bulgarian to me.
That's it. I'm calling the police.
Our service isn't on yet.
Fine. Jasper, give me your phone.
Dead battery, Ma.
Then we'll get mine out of the car. Come on, you two.
Oh, what are we going to do? We've got to get that bracelet back. That inscription must be some kind of spell or charm.
Oh, and that's how the wax figures came to life.
Too bad that bracelet can't help us figure out how to stop Violet Sneed.
Maybe it can.
Julie, you've got that gleam in your eye.
I think I might know of a way as to how we can get Violet Seed off our backs and get that bracelet back.
Oh dear! Who's it?
The necklace might be sharp!
Could it be Lizzie Borden?
Jolene, we don't have a Lizzie Borden!
Oh,
what do you think this is, Dancing with the Stars?
I didn't know you were gonna stop so fast.
Maybe I'll flash my brake lights next time.
Looks okay down here, huh?
Any of you crazy people down here?
You think they'd tell us if there were?
Coast is clear. And maybe.
We should have stayed in the break room like Miss Fairchild said.
Look, I know those crazy pirates, whatever they were just outside the window.
How did you know?
I could smell the rum.
So, just to be clear, we're safe down here, right?
But this place is even creepier than upstairs. Yeah. Hey, guys, look at these plates. They're ancient and look like something Madame Bovary could have used.
Do you guys think these boxes actually have dynamite in them?
Dynamite? No, of course not. This is a wax museum. Only the plates and stuff are real.
Those pirates look pretty real to me.
Hey, I got it!
Got what?
We're being bought!
Oh my god! Oh my god! Are we on scare tactic? Candid camera?
No. America's Funniest Home Videos.
Oh, I love that.
Miss Fairchild is trying to win the $100,000?
Yeah, but we'll make her split with us.
Shh! Someone's coming! How do you know?
I told you, I can smell the rum.
So let's just play along.
Well, me hearties! Look what we've got here!
Looks like somebody captured the goods.
But not very good goods.
I don't see any gold.
Not a jewel in sight.
Not even a shrunken head.
This would never have happened back home.
I hunted down a merchant ship.
Laden with treasures too numerous to count.
What? I wouldn't give to go back.
We find the treasure, mateys. It'll be just like the good old days. Guys are really good, you know that?
Well, I mean, the cabin boy's back!
Cabin boy? I'm Victor Thunder, the ultimate fighter.
And we're his fans.
Why?
Nice costumes. Did he pick them up at Walmart?
Costumes, he might be brazen.
You're talking to Aunt Bonnie, Mary Reed, and me, Madam Ching.
Are those names supposed to mean something to us?
Aye, we're the fiercest lady pirates on the high seas.
You're not fooling us again.
But, I mean, you sure look the part.
I would have expected, like, a bit more of a beard, though.
Ouch!
String out from the yard arm.
Excuse me. There's only yard arm for 150 miles around here.
Yeah, you gotta wake up pretty early if you're gonna fool us, just saying.
Kids, are you down? Here.
Oh, Heather, I'm a spare child.
Who was really that? Good. As if you didn't know.
Kids, you have to listen to me.
We figured it out. I mean, sure, we don't always do our own work.
But we know when our legs are being pulled.
That's it. We string up by the legs and dangle them over the sharks.
The first one to get the head snapped off is the winner.
They're really good, Miss Fairchild, like top notch.
Yeah, you can even smell the rum. That's because they're real.
Aye, my fine beauty. And what a guess you'd be!
Whoa.
Don't worry, Miss Fairchild, we'll protect you. Okay.
So, no. My little friend, you want to play rough?
You guys have hands like vice grips.
Quiet!
Maybe we can work out sometime. Oh.
One more word out of your mouth and I'll tear out your tongue and let it flap in the sun.
We'll flame like a herring.
Let's split him from belly to back.
You don't need to do that.
No.
Let him go.
Ugh. No, no.
Meanie, meanie, miney, mo. You will be the first to go.
Oh, Joel, that is a plastic sword, pal. Just show her what you're made of.
Rolf, it's like metal. Really sharp metal.
Can peel the hide off a gator in 5 seconds.
Wow, that's really cool.
And I'm inclined to say it'll peel your hide in less time than that. Want to test the theory?
No, sir. I'm good. I'll take your word for it.
I thought as much.
Now, Mr. Blackbeard, sir, please don't hurt us. I have to apologize for my students. They're rude and unruly, but they're too young to understand. She's really into this.
Then we'll knock some sense into it.
But if you hurt us, you'll never find the treasure.
Treasure? You know what the treasure be?
It's worth a king's ransom.
Gold? Jewels?
Even a few mutual funds?
Tell us or you die!
Arr!
Now, please let me go, nice captain. I know you have good manners despite what the history books say. And please let them go. I don't take orders from you.
But you do from me. Let him go or I'll feed your gizzard to a crow.
Okay. You said I'm gonna do it.
But this time, I will. Tell me where the treasure is, or I'll feed your gizzard to a crow.
Wow.
Who are they?
What? Looky here. If it ain't a costume party.
Who are they? Oh, you got names, pretty boy?
Butch Cassidy, man.
Ma'am? Why, she's a stinky, you're old battle axe than I am.
Who be you, Skunktail?
Calamity Jane, that's who. Best shot in this side of Mississippi. What in tarnation are you?
Miss Fairchild, you went through so much trouble to trick us.
Oh, this is no trick, Emily. I can't explain it, but that's Butch Cassidy and the Sundance Kid, and that's Pancho Villa.
Buenas noches.
Sayonara.
And that's Calamity Jane, and they all know about Rufus Ravenscroft's treasure.
Aye! And it's boiled be ours!
Nah, I hate to disagree, partner, but that their treasure's ours.
But dang, this whole gal's upstairs sent us a wild goose shape.
So, where's the treasure?
She be telling us, not you.
We beg to differ, you old sea swab.
Them's fighting words, you two-bit cowpoke!
Wrong, matey!
That gal who knows where the treasure is gave us the slip.
Why, that'd be a pretty foxy move.
What do you expect from a pretty foxy lady?
Mateys! After him!
Aye, aye, Captain!
Shimmer me,
anchors away!
Aye, Chihuahua, they must have had the bellyache.
Maybe they ran off this way, Butch.
You're right, Calam. Tracks head right out that door.
There you are. Why, if it ain't the sneaky lion claim jumper.
We stake you out on the anthill.
There were no treasure where you said.
We know that now. That's why we wanted to find you. Really, Mr. Cassidy, we didn't want you to leave empty-handed.
So where's the treasure?
It was stolen.
Did the pirates get to it first?
No, but we know who did.
No kidding. You don't say. Well, come on, fellas. We gotta get us a couple of no-good rats.
Sodal, when Moss sells his dump and gets 5 million from the mall developer, you and me can take a real nice trip somewhere, someplace like Atlantic City or Myrtle Beach.
How about someplace really romantic like Bulgaria?
What are you doing, Polly?
Don't I make just about the prettiest bride you ever saw?
Bride?
You know, someone a guy marries.
Who said anything about getting married?
You were talking about a honeymoon, weren't you?
Well, I mean,
I wouldn't go to the Piggly Wiggly with you unless we married.
That's a pretty big step, Polly.
But you'll take that step for me, won't you, Jasper?
All the dumb things. No cell phone service. What are you two doing down here?
Jasper is just about to propose.
Propose what?
That we take the car and report all of this to the police.
You ain't going no place.
The old lady, she tells us the truth.
You slapped the treasure.
And we don't like folks who don't share.
What are you doing?
Get that rope off me.
What do you think we are, cattle?
Head them up and move them out.
Where are you taking us?
Have a heart. We were on our way to get married.
You were what?
On second thought, go ahead and shoot us.
So, like, you really haven't set us up, Miss Fairchild?
Wouldn't even know how.
But then, what are these things doing running around all over the place?
Aunt Jolene thinks some sort of ancient spell is at work. Look, all I know is no one's gonna be happy until we find that treasure.
But there are a lot of boxes in the break room.
Maybe we can look in there. But what are we looking for? I don't know, but I have a feeling we'll know when we see it. You guys go on, I'll check through this stuff to see if I can find any clues.
Break room, go to the break room, guys. Check stuff.
You know you're coming, right?
Yeah, I'll be right behind y'all.
Yeah.
Go to the break room.
Why not leave
that? Oh, I'll be your bodyguard, Miss Fairchild.
Is your name Roll?
Yeah?
One of the girls was looking for you.
Which one?
Yeah, the pretty looking one.
Oh!
thank you, Mr. Webster.
Quite all right, Miss Fairchild. You realize the effect you have on the male species.
I think you're exaggerating.
Not at all. I have to be an expert on the subject.
There you go again, knowing it all.
There's one thing I don't know. Why are you still angry at me for something that happened over 5 years ago?
You know what? I haven't even thought about that night for the past 5 years until I saw you again.
Well, haven't I changed?
You have, Mr. Webster. You're so much more, well, you know.
There's one more thing I don't know.
Then I'm not gonna tell you.
Can you forgive me?
What kind of girl do you think I am?
Oh, kind, generous, intelligent, beautiful, and forgiving?
I bet you say that to all the girls. You can let go of me now.
I can let go of you?
I mean, I just didn't want you to get hurt by that crazy lady.
Well, I'm glad I have you to protect me then.
Shouldn't it be the other way around?
Whatever you say, Miss Fairchild.
There she be, matey!
Fire!
Nab her!
We'll get the truth out of her if it's the last thing she ever does!
Oh, you think it's a top, mate?
We'll make fast work on this one, hey, mateys?
Blackbeard, I think we're being rusty.
Pull back, lads! Hoist the mainsail! Right up the yardarms! Set sail for Treasure Island!
Well, no, that's pretty good. What's good, line? Next time, pick on some of your own size!
Let's hope there's no next time, partner.
Arr!
Cleo.
You're everything I look for in a woman.
Oh, you're so sweet. What do you love most about me? My eyes?
They're dazzling.
My lips?
Delicious.
My beautifully manicured hands?
And what jewels? They're fit for a king. But didn't you mention that you had a nice little spread back east?
Oh, just an old delta in all of North Africa?
Room to stretch out in. England is getting rather cramped.
So here you are!
Oh, so like a bad penny.
Look, lady, I don't see why you have to lose your head over this.
We're not going there, okay?
Then what do you want, Anne?
I want it all.
What?
I want London, I want France.
She even wants your underpants.
And I got a lawyer who can make it happen. Come here, John.
Ah, you found him, I see.
Well, who's this?
John Adams, second president of the United States, Mr. President.
It's an order, sir.
Yes, well, thank you.
What is this precedent?
By United what?
The United States, the first independent and free democratic nation in history.
Mr. Adams here was one of the founding fathers.
I don't care how many kids you've got, we don't want you butting into our business.
Well, you see, madam, I've been retained by Ms. Tudor and Boland to represent her interests.
Give him the papers, John.
Yes, I've got them right here.
Cleo, what are we going to do?
I don't know about you, but I'm in denial. Hey, get back here! Henry, don't you run out on me?
Oh dear, where can those papers be?
Oh my god, who else is running amok around here?
Oh, Heather, hurry!
It's wrong!
The pirates, they've captured your students!
Senora.
I say we blow them to kingdom come right now.
You can't do that.
How come?
Because I'm too young to die.
Then tell us what you did with the treasure.
We don't have any treasure.
Go on, that's where the little lady told us you swiped it.
She's lying.
Grandmama never lies.
So spill it or you'll be sitting on the roof the hard way.
Bring him in here, mateys.
Then we'll figure a way to make him talk.
Looks like we got company. Itching for a licking? Ha!
You landlubbers can't hold a candle to Blackbeard the pirate.
You'd blow up if you did.
Arr!
The only ones who are gonna blow up are these three.
We don't have any treasure, kids. Tell them.
They have it. I saw them with it.
What? She's lying.
Yeah, they found the treasure. That true whippersnapper?
Why, no, madam, but did anybody ever tell you got a really, really, really cute smile?
Why? Ain't that sweet?
Go on, Calabri. He's just buttering you up.
Nothing wrong with a little butter sun dance.
Just look at the bracelet she's wearing. They have it.
This old thing?
Got it at the dollar store.
Hey, give that back.
Why?
It's right pretty. But it sure ain't no treasure.
Hold on, you seafaring slobs.
Who you calling a seafaring slob, you prairie pigeon?
Come to think of it, you do remember the sea. You made me sick.
Oh, you're a real lady killer, matey. One look at you and they die of fright.
See, senora, when you were born, your papa, he threw rocks at the stork.
That's so. Well, if you're twice as smart, you'd still be stupid.
Gal, why don't you sit back down and give your mind a rest?
Oh, my God. Oh, dear.
What's going on here?
Stop it! Stop this fighting!
Now, I want this stopped immediately.
But, ma'am, they started it.
Yeah! Shiver me timbers! To us the who jumped us!
Just get us off this dynamite!
Yeah, could blow any minute.
Oh, that's not dynamite. It
says TNT right on the box.
Rufus Ravenscraw put his breakables in there.
He didn't think the shippers would handle with care if he just wrote fragile on them.
I have all the dirty tricks. That's pretty clever.
Maybe Danny holding a treasure.
You tell your two idiots here to knock off the R stuff!
My idiots? I thought they were yours!
Everyone!
How about this rope?
We found the treasure under some old books in the break room closet!
Let's see the booty!
Oh, hope it's a lot prettier than that old bracelet.
Cleopatra's bracelet!
So, what is in the container?
Jewels?
Doubloons? It's an Egyptian jar.
Open it, open it! Don't you dare open that jar! That's mine!
And just who might you two be?
Queen Cleopatra of Egypt.
And I, sir.
And Henry VIII.
King of England.
Yeah, right. And I'm Santa Claus.
Hey!
Get back! Get
there! What?
Hey, you're just a girl.
Chauvinist.
Thanks, man. I'll
sit back.
Get in!
I want that jar!
For my sake! I'm gonna like y'all!
It's got her liver inside!
Ew!
The mud.
Oliver.
It's been a long time since we've been together.
Enough of this family reunion! You tricked us, gal!
That'd be a nice try, matey, but where's the real treasure?
You are thick? River Starcroft never had a real treasure. He abandoned it.
You're a lying snake in the grass.
Don't you call Skip a snake in the grass.
Oh.
You went and kicked Butch Cassidy?
Last man who tried that got decorated 32 bullet holes.
If you want to shoot Miss Fairchild, you have to go through us first.
Emily, can we talk to you? He has a gun.
No! Emily's right. Yeah, these big bullies need to be put in their place.
Bullies?
Yeah, which means you're all probably suffering from inferiority complexes.
Except me. I'm inferior to no one.
Henry, are you down there?
Don't let her find me!
Where is he, you strumpet?
You dare call Cleopatra Queen of Denial a strumpet? What's a strumpet?
Oh, well, it's like a floozy. Only worse.
Yeah, just checking.
Now, Anne, let's be reasonable about this.
This is John Adams. He's a lawyer.
Uh-oh. How do you do, Mr. Tudor?
That's your majesty to you.
This is the United States, Mr. Tudor. We've eliminated royal titles.
Hear that, Mr. Tudor? So go ahead, give him the papers.
Yes, I've got them right here.
What are these papers, Anne?
Property settlement papers, Henry.
Well, whose property?
Yours, and I want it all.
Oh, dear.
Mr. Adams, these are letters.
Yes, from Abigail. She does still like to write.
And a report from Paris signed by Benjamin Franklin.
Oh, dear. I forgot to give that one to George Washington.
And what's this?
I really need Abigail to go through my pockets occasionally and clean some of this out. Here you are, Mr. Tudor. You'll see that the terms are agreeable. My client, Anne Boleyn, gets Hampton Courts, you get the tower. She gets the silver, you get the lead. She gets the flowers, and you get the weeds.
Oh my! Oh my! Oh my!
Lady, you sit on a cactus or something?
The treasure! The treasure!
That there's just paper.
What is it actually?
It's a draft of the Bill of Rights!
But are you sure?
Congress shall make no law abridging the freedom of speech or press.
Oh my!
Jimmy Madison sent that to me back in the fall of 1789 to get my opinion.
But there are more than 10 amendments listed on here.
A few of them got crossed out, too specific.
That's no treasure.
But it is. The Bill of Rights is the foundation of freedom.
Exactly. That draft is priceless.
Visitors will come from everywhere to the Cultley Museum to see this monumental piece of history.
Hold on there. We're part of this here museum. Doesn't that make us piece history too?
I run an exactly chopped liver.
Speak for yourself, sweetie.
Lady's right.
Calam? A lady?
But she's right. All you wax figures are here because you're part of history.
Boom. We're learning all about you.
Boom.
And you're all in the history books.
Boom.
For better or for worse, you all will be quite an attraction for Cultley Wax Museum, and people will come from near and far because of this national treasure.
If that paper's so valuable, lady, we want it!
Aye, we can hold it for ransom!
Sounds like a good idea.
We can do that too.
No, you can't. It's one of the great documents of history.
Boom.
Yeah, it belongs to every citizen who treasures freedom.
Oh yeah? It belongs to whoever's got it. Right, boys?
Stay back! Stay back! Stay back, horse!
Out of my way, landlubber, or I'll skew your liver and put it in jar.
You know, we all hold an important place in history.
Miss Fairchild, go on!
But this is history run muck. It can't go on like this.
That bracelet goes into this mess. It's got to get us out. Now, where did I put it?
Looks like I'm not the only one who needs to organize their belongings.
Now, I understand you have to go, but I must say, it has been a true honor meeting you in person.
Thank you. And knowing that our work for freedom has stood the test of time is knowledge I will always treasure.
Are you sure you can't stay? I mean, we still have so much more to learn from you. Got it!
Thank you, but this is not where I belong. Goodbye, friends.
I want that treasure!
Thank you.
okay in here.
Hey, look. Thank God they're all waxed again.
I think she was really into me.
Oh my God. She had kings and emperors drooling all over her role.
Yeah, definitely out of your class.
Whatever.
What's up with the two of you? You sound like real history buffs. Well, we did learn a few things.
I want to learn more about Butch Cassidy and the Sundance Kid.
How'd they end up in Bolivia?
What if they got on Anne Boleyn? She lived such a tragic romance.
You know who I want to learn about? Those lady pirates.
They were enough to scare anybody.
And what about Calamity Jane? She could have twisted Victor into a pretzel.
True.
No way!
Everything okay in here?
Did what we think happened actually happen?
Maybe we were just dreaming.
Yeah, when you said we were going to go on a history lesson, Miss Fairchild, we had no idea what we were getting into.
Believe me, neither did I.
Hey, did you know John Adams and Thomas Jefferson died on the same day?
Mary Read dressed like a man to prove herself in battle.
Yeah, but then she fell in love with a Flemish soldier. Isn't that sweet?
Butch and Sundance hit it at a place called Hole in the Wall.
Pancho Villa once invaded New Mexico.
Madam Chink commanded 2,000 ships and 50,000 pirates.
Heather, it sounds like you sparked some interest again. It is okay if I can call you Heather, right?
As long as I can call you Skip.
And maybe we could go for that dinner this evening. Kind of a rain check?
I don't know. I mean, I have a lot of papers to correct, so...
Not if we don't do our homework.
Are you blackmailing me?
Whatever works.
All right, Skip. It's a date.
No! Yep. Mortar or not, I'll be there.
Everyone all right?
It's like nothing happened.
Except that we found the treasure.
And I mean, it's locked up in the safe. I already left the message at the Smithsonian so they can appraise the document.
And look, all our friends are back where they belong.
So, how did this all happen?
It was the bracelet, young man. Cleopatra's bracelet. There was an inscription on it. Read it one way, and it turned figures to life. Read it backwards, and they revert back to wax.
What a coincidence.
So, it's possible that they can still hear us.
Well, maybe. So I guess we'd better watch ourselves.
We better put that bracelet in their lock and key and make sure this never happens again.
Hey, wait a minute. Where's Miss Sneed? They're two pet rats.
Well, I imagine they ran out the back door.
Miss Fairchild, you don't have any information here on Lizzie Borden.
That's because we don't have a Lizzie Borden.
What? But we saw her carrying an axe.
Oh, hey, hey, hey!
Agent Davis Pinkerter, Special Investigator for the IRS.
And what were you doing here all this time?
Investigating a big case of tax fraud, undercover.
But that's impossible! The Coldplay Society always pays its taxes! I see to it myself!
Oh, you're just fine, but I checked the culprits here, and I'm hauling them in for questioning.
Those wax parts back again!
Quick, do the spell again!
Don't worry, they have me also undercover.
Agent Whipper, Agent Snapper, FBI, order!
I didn't think we had that many wax pirates.
You can't do this.
Yeah, we've got our rights.
I don't even know these two.
Why, Miss Sneed, we'll take very good care of your building while you're gone.
It's not fair.
Yeah, this place is a loony bin.
You wanna see what they got going on here?
We're gonna report this place.
Don't waste your time, lady. I saw it all, and I still don't believe it.
She said it in all my 83 years. I've never experienced a day like today.
It's definitely one for the history books.